Welcome to Microwave Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining Gyrator in microwave, and for that, these are my session outlines, where I'll be explaining first basics of Gyrator, then we'll show symbol of Gyrator, then I'll explain scattering matrix which is there with Gyrator, then we'll see how Gyrator functions, and then how Gyrator is having relationship with transformer, that we'll be going to discuss about, and then I'll explain one basic structure of Gyrator, and then we'll see applications to some of this session. So now let us begin this session with basics of Gyrator. So Gyrator, that is basically a non-reciprocal ferrite device in which we use ferrite material, and how it functions that we'll see later in this session. Gyrator is having following characteristic. It is linear in nature. It is lossless. It is a passive component. It is a memoryless component, and it is basically a two-port device. That is similar to ideal transformer, but there is a difference in between ideal transformer and Gyrator that I'll explain at the later part, like how it is having a relevance. So that we'll see at the end of this session. Now, this is what the basic symbol which is there with Gyrator, and this symbol that is based on its functioning, like one can clearly see here we have port 1 and this is port 2. If we give input at port 1, then there will be output at port 2 with pi amount of phase shift, means 180 degree phase shift will be there. But if we insert signal at port 2, there will be no phase shift that is there at port 1. So ultimately, in one direction, there will be a phase shift of 180 degree, but in other direction from port 2 to port 1, there is no phase shift. So that is how it functions. If we see its scattering matrix, then scattering matrix of Gyrator, that is of two port scattering matrix. So it is what? Ideal device, so there is no loss when we insert signal at port 1. So S11, that is 0, as well as S22, that is 0. But when we see S21 means input at port 1, output at port 2. So there will be 180 degree phase shift. So S21 is minus 1. And when we insert signal at port 2, output at port 1 will be exactly similar to the input. So output and input is same in case of input is given to port 2. So ultimately S12, that is 1. So that is how Gyrator functions, and even scattering matrix that we can understand based on same. Let us move on to next point, working of Gyrator. So as we have discussed earlier, it is a two port device, and it is having relative phase shift of 180 degree in forward direction, as if we insert signal at port 1 and output at port 2 is having 180 degree phase shift, and there will be zero phase shift in case of reverse direction, means if input at port 2, there will be zero phase shift at port 1. When signal is transmitted from port 1 to port 2, it offers 180 degree, and when it transforms from port 2 to port 1, it offers zero phase shift. So one can say it is what? Differential phase shift device. Relationship of Gyrator with transformer. Now, as we all know, transformer, that is working based on phenomenon of mutual induction, and in which if we insert AC signal at winding 1, that will get coupled to winding 2, and in that we don't find any phase difference, means if we give voltage signal at input, voltage signal at output will happen. And if we insert current signal at input, current signal at output will happen, and vice versa case will happen in case of transformer. But the difference in transformer and Gyrator is, if we input voltage at port 1, there will be a transformation into current at port 2. And if we insert current at port 1, there will be a transformation in voltage at port 2. Means there will be a phase difference of 180 degree from port 1 to port 2. While in case of input at port 2, voltage to voltage and voltage to current is not happening. So ultimately voltage to voltage in case of port 2 as well as current to current in case of port 2 is happening in case of greater. So how our transformer couples voltage on port 1 to voltage on port 2 and current on port 1 to current on port 2, but greater cross couples voltage to current and current to voltage in case of transformation from port 1 to port 2. Now, working of greater, so that we have already seen. Now greater, if we cascade two greater in sequence, it will be having a functioning like ideal transformer. How? The reason is, if we connect two greater in cascading, in that case first greater will convert voltage to current and second greater will convert current to voltage. So at the end you will be having voltage to voltage. And if we cascade that too, and if we insert current at port 1, then what will happen is current to voltage will happen by first greater and second greater will translate voltage to current. So ultimately at the end you will be having current to current. So two greater cascaded will result into ideal transformer. Now if we see structure of greater, one basic structure, that is what I have shown over here. So this is what the basic structure of greater, where these are electrodes at port 1 and this is coil at port 2. So when we insert signal at 1, at output side voltage to current and current to voltage is happening. But if we insert signal at port 2, voltage to voltage and current to current transformation is happening. And ultimately basic idea behind greater is to have removal of inductance. And how we can have removal of inductance at load side, that is the basic agenda. And that is what happening based on transformation of voltage to current. The reason is phase difference, that will be of 180 degree, and that is what the case which happens in case of inductor. Like for example, if you insert low frequency signal, then that is what almost similar to short circuit in case of inductance. So in terms of current there is no phase, but in terms of voltage you will be finding it is appear delayed by 180 degree. So ultimately the basic agenda is, if you want to remove that in case of inductance circuit connection, then that could be getting done by having a gyrator where greater provides removal of inductance at the load side. And based on that there are so many applications, so let us try to understand those applications. So primary goal is to reduce size of circuit by removing inductor. It could be used in telephony devices, and that could be connected in POTS system, parametric equalizer, band pass filter, anywhere it could be utilized where we can replace inductor to reduce size of circuit. So whenever you find any circuit in which bulky element like inductor is connected, then to reduce size as well as to reduce weight of that circuit, one can replace inductor by connecting greater. So this is what the basic agenda behind greater. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any suggestion regarding this, you can place that in comments, as well as you can ask questions regarding greater. Definitely I'll get back to you to reply back to your questions. Thank you so much for watching this video.